Data analytics tools are obviously key tools that any data analyst or data scientist needs to know how to use. So how do you pick which one that you should learn? I'm going to go through four different tools that I think are great options to learn and how you pick between them if you're just getting started. Hi, I'm Jen. Welcome to the channel. For this analytic tools comparison, I'm going to use two main criteria that I think are really at the heart of the decision on which tool to learn. The first is how widely used is it? And that ties into how many jobs are there that are available for people that have the skill set. And then my second criteria is how easy is it to learn? Because if you can learn it pretty quickly, you can add it to your bank of skills, throw it on your resume, and give yourself more options for jobs. Since this review is really focused on analysts, data analysts, and data scientists that are making decisions about which tools to use, I'm specifically not going to focus on decision factors that companies use in order to figure out which of these softwares that they want to implement within their company. So if it's expensive, doesn't matter. You're not footing the bill, the company is. But that could impact how many companies are using it and the job availability. I'm also not going to look much at the IT setup that's required for them. Again, this is more of a company decision, and it'll show up a little bit in available jobs, but it's not really something that you should be too concerned with the logistics of in deciding which software that you want to learn. We also won't really talk about customer support for these options, though I will say all of the four different tools that I'm going to go through either have fantastic customer support from the company, or there's a wealth of resources online and other users that will help work out any problem that you have with any of them. So I wouldn't be concerned from that aspect that if you get stuck, that you're not going to have help. You'll have it, whether it's from the company or other users in any of these. The first tool, Python. Python is most popular at startups and smaller companies that are really concerned with cost. So I guess I did talk a little bit about cost there, but that talks more about the opportunity that's out there. Right now, in terms of job postings and what programming language they require, Python's actually the most prevalent. So there are a lot of good reasons, a lot of good job opportunities for learning Python. In terms of learning Python, it's pretty simple to learn Python, and there's a lot of good documentation for it. The one major drawback is there's not a common GUI interface for it, and this can be a drawback depending on your level of skills and how much you're going to build them. Some of other tools like SAS have a fantastic GUI interface, and so you can use a mix of knowing how to code, but also just really understanding the logic of how things go together to do your work. So that's one drawback, not a reason not to learn it. There's obviously a lot of advantages, a lot of jobs that want you to have it, but that's our first option. Second is R. R is another option that a lot of startups or smaller companies concerned with cost efficiency are really focused on. And it's also second in terms of number of job openings associated with that programming language. Of the four different tools I'm recommending that you consider learning, R is definitely the hardest. Part of this is because by its nature, it's a really basic language. It means that some things that you can do really elegantly and quickly in other languages, you can't do in R. It might take a lot of code to be able to do really complex things. The great thing is because you learn the basics and then you use basics to create anything that you want, is it can be very versatile for you to learn how to do new things because you're not learning a lot of new ways of working. So there are a lot of advantages from that perspective, but if you're doing a lot of coding, it can get really tedious to do long amounts of code for complex things that you could do in some cases, one or two lines in some of the other programming languages. Third, SAS. This is the third most job openings of the three I'm talking about in this section, but it isn't really that much behind. There isn't a big gap between Python, R, and SAS. The main reason that you would learn SAS, even though it's number three on the list in terms of popularity, is there are a lot of industries where SAS is really the only analytic software that they're using, or at least the main analytic software that they're using. If you're going into healthcare or banking, there's a 95% chance the company that you're going into for data analytics is going to be using SAS. It is a really powerful tool. It's expensive to set up, but there are a lot of great things about the tool. SAS also has the highest market share in private organizations. So again, industry specific, but if that's the industry you want to go into, SAS is critical. The other thing that I expect will help SAS in the future is they are one of the most heavily invested in research and work on AI and predictive analytics, which we all know is growing. We see it around us all the time. This may end up pushing it above some of these other programming languages, or at least becoming the main market player in this area as we get into more AI heavy tech. In terms of ease of learning, SAS can be really easy to medium. They have great interfaces for the user to use. For instance, if you're using their Enterprise Guide product, then you don't really actually have to know any coding to do the majority of work, though there are things that you can't do directly in it that you will have to know how to code. And there are some times where it's much quicker to put in a little bit of code than to do everything through the interface. But it's a great way to learn it and to get your foot in the door with coding. If you have a background in SQL, those skills also translate really well into SAS. It will be very easy for you to pick up the SAS language. The fourth tool is one everyone should know, Excel. You have to know Excel as an analyst. I know it makes a lot of people cringe. They want to use the heavy tools. They want to use the elegant, the eloquent, different programming languages. But at the end of the day, Excel does a lot. And if you're working with small amounts of data, which you're going to be at some point, even if you're a big data analyst, at some point you're going to be working with small amounts of data in your day where it's just quicker to use Excel. It's also widely available. It's pretty cheap. Most of us have it on our desktops. Even if you don't have Excel, if you have an open source version, it's going to be fairly similar. In terms of job outlook, you're probably not going to get an analyst role solely based on Excel, though there are some Excel data analyst jobs out there, so you can't completely discount it. It's just going to be a little less prevalent. Most analytics roles, and certainly any data science roles, you're going to have to know one of the other three tools that I talked about. The other reason that knowing Excel is a good place to start is because the framework that you build, the skills that you learn in the logic and how things tie together is really useful in any system you're working on. I truly believe the hardest part of solving any analytics problem or doing any analysis isn't the actual in the software analysis work, it's figuring out all the logic you want to use to get there. You can figure out, you can find people online, you can contact the company to find out the exact mechanics of implementing it in the software, but knowing that logic is really the central piece, the central skill set that you're bringing. So getting familiar with that in Excel makes it that much easier in all of the other systems. Which of these tools do you utilize the most, or which ones are you now more interested in learning after watching this video? Let me know in the comments. We'll talk more about everything analytics in the coming weeks. So I look forward to seeing you back here.